determine for you guys who gets the starting nod?
Well, Aaron has done a nice job, and unfortunately, you know, Steve got hurt with the high ankle sprain during spring practice. But as Steve started coming back, you started to see why he, you know, he played a lot, and why he made a lot of tackles, because Steve is a very smart player. I mean, he's like the quarterback on offense, the defense. He calls the fronts and makes the adjustments, and a lot of times it affects, you know, the secondary and what they're doing. And you can just see over the course of August practices and here up until here recently that, you know, Steve has an eye for the football. He understands the game, and he puts himself in position to make plays. So actually he's made the competition at that position, you know, much more fierce, because now Aaron knows that he's got to be on his P's and Q's. I mean, Steve's, you know, his best attributes were getting us lined up and being able to understand formations and making those coverage calls and things, and which has caused Aaron to have to step up, you know. So it's been healthy competition. Both of them will play a lot. So it's a good position to be in. I'm quite sure for both of them that no one has anything over the other one. We're going to need both of them to play.
Coach, what's the biggest difference between an FCS school and an FBS school since you were at one last year and now you're playing?
Well, obviously the numbers in terms of scholarship numbers, you know, 85 for BCS and, you know, 63, you know, for FCS. And I think that a lot of those kids being on the other side now, there are times when, you know, they have not had opportunities to be recruited by, quote-unquote, a BCS school. And, you know, sometimes that's a motivating factor for them because, you know, they started out wanting to be recruited and things just worked out that it didn't happen that way. Lawrence Sidbury was a guy that probably should have been in a 1A school when he was at Richmond. He just did a fantastic job, you know, and those are motivators, I know, for young men like that. So sometimes you think at the BCS level that you have the best of the best athletes that are out there, and, you know, sometimes that may be the case, but a lot of times it's not. I mean, you can't measure the heart of a young man or an individual. And I'm quite sure that having been on both sidelines now, that part of it, you know, for them is, you know, they want to play at this venue, hopefully be a great crowd, the ESPN game. They want to play against so-called, you know, BCS athletes. And at the same time, we're going to have to be able to, you know, match and exceed whatever excitement and enthusiasm that they bring, because this is a very good team. You know, all things considered, you know, we're a team that lost to Duke last year, and Richmond was a team that beat Duke. You know, so you can't take any of this lightly. And I just think that, you know, like I said, we're going to have to match the energy and the excitement that they bring. But the fact that this is our home opener, home game, and a chance for us to kind of change our own fortunes, you know, makes it very important for us also.
Mike, how do you feel about your starting quarterback, Marc Verica, coming into the season after you've worked with him and seen him in camp for a few weeks? And maybe you could also talk about how the depth chart kind of came to be here with Mike Rocco on there too.
Right. But, you know, Mark's done a great job of handling the offense and making the plays and running the offense. Now it's going to be on him to make the throws, to be efficient, to distribute the ball. You know, not to make mental errors, not to force throws, and just kind of manage things. He's a fifth-year guy. He's been in a lot of games, and he should do that. You know, the tricky part was choosing that second quarterback. I mean, no one between Ross and Michael Rocco really have separated themselves from each other. So with that being in mind, you know, both of them are listed on the same line. And it just all depends on how the game is going, you know, which one will go in the game. And that'll be determined as the game goes on. So we're looking for a clear second, but, you know, we don't have it right now. We have two guys on the same line, and they're going to have to compete even this week, you know, to find out who will be the first to go in the game should anything happen to Mark.